Have you been avoiding artificial sweeteners such as aspartame? You are probably not even aware, but the chances are that you have consumed an artificial sweetener within the past 24 hours. Low-calorie and artificial sweeteners are used in so many products, such as cereals, juices, desserts, soft drinks, chewing gum, toothpaste, and even some medicines contain artificial sweeteners. Even if you are not very health-conscious, you have probably heard that aspartame can be very bad for you. While a lot of tests and studies have been done on aspartame, there's no definitive agreement as to whether aspartame is actually that bad for you. So, here is how aspartame is made. Aspartame is produced from two amino acids, phenylalanine and aspartic acid. Although these amino acids are both naturally occurring in food, aspartame itself is not natural and must be manufactured by various synthetic and chemical pathways. Although aspartame has been approved by the Food and Drug Administration, there are some claims about the long and short-term negative effects of aspartame consumption. Even though most of these effects have not been officially confirmed, you probably don't want to take the risk and would rather have a sweetener that is less controversial and a bit more natural, and perhaps something that is entirely plant-based. Although the search for healthier alternatives is still ongoing, we may have already found one. In the last decade, a new sweetener has been introduced that is natural and completely plant-based. It is called Stevia. Stevia has become increasingly popular as a natural alternative to aspartame because it is directly made from the leaves of the plant, Stevia ribodiana. Stevia comes originally from South America, but is nowadays grown all over the world. Natives of those countries have been sweetening their drinks and foods with the stevia plant for centuries. Stevia is specifically grown for its sweet leaves and is a lot sweeter than sugar and many other synthetic sweeteners. Stevia is often lumped together with other sweeteners like Splenda or Sweetenlow, but it is actually quite different. Stevia has minimal effects on blood glucose and can boost glucose tolerance, making it an excellent option for diabetics and others on low-carbohydrate diets. The only disadvantage compared to aspartame is that stevia has a distinctive licorice aftertaste, which can be a turnoff for some people. Aspartame, on the other hand, is one of the few artificial sweeteners that resembles sugar the most in taste and has no strange aftertaste. So, aspartame would be a winner when it comes to taste. So, is stevia safe? A lot of research and health organizations across the world say yes. But that doesn't mean that all the stevia products you can get in store are actually natural. Some stevia that you can buy in the store is a highly processed that has very little real stevia leaves left in it. Some of the most famous brands that are said to contain stevia have almost no stevia in them at all. To get the stevia that is not highly processed and that is most natural, there are some important things that you must look out for. I have tried to figure out the good and the bad, and I'm excited to share what I have learned. To learn more about different types and brands of stevia and which one is the best and most natural, follow the link in the description below this video, where you will find my full article about stevia and everything you need to know about this plant-based sweetener. Check it out now.